All right, if you're using a spreadsheet, you can use it as a list, you can use it to record things, but if you want to do anything more, and you can do a whole lot more, you have to learn how to use formulas. So in this video, we're going to go over all the basics about how to use formulas. In this video, though, it's actually a lot different than it would have been 5 years ago. So as you'll see as we go along, Google Sheets offers a lot of help, and you can use it. We're going to talk about how to use that help, but then also how to write a formula yourself, because you'll have to do that as well when you go along, because Google Sheets doesn't always guess right. But we'll start out with this spreadsheet that you see on the screen right now. And you can get a copy of this spreadsheet if you want to follow along. The link is in the description. But what we'll start to do is we will just add this column of numbers here to get the total units. And there's a built-in function for how to do that. So a function can be part of a formula. So a formula is everything that comes into the cell when we're doing this. A function is something that can go inside a formula, but it's a preset instruction to Google Sheets. So an example of this would be sum. And that just tells Google Sheets to add what you're going to tell it to add. So we'll start out with that easy example. We're going to be in cell C7. So that's column C, row 7. And we'll start out by hitting an equal sign. So you always start out a formula with an equal sign. That's like a shortcut to let Google Sheet know that you're not just going to type a number, you're not going to type text, you're actually going to type a formula. And Google Sheets now is already suggesting the sum formula. So we were going to sum these numbers. That's the most common thing to do, so that's what it guessed. And we'll just take that guess for now. We'll show you how to do that. So it has written it out in gray. There's one small problem with it is that it wants to add the header as well, but that won't hurt anything. Since that's just text, it will count as nothing. So it won't throw the sum off. So you could just do what's in here, sum C2, and there's the colon there, which means go all the way through to C6. And it's also telling you the answer already, which is 208. But if you hit the tab key, that will perform that operation. And now in that cell, when you double click in it, or when you look in the formula bar here, but we'll double click in it, that formula is in there. So one of the things to keep in mind about this formula and why it's so much more powerful than using a calculator is if you go up, let's say we'll change 36 to 40. If you look at the total, it is 208 now, it updates to 212. All right, so these functions and formulas, when you put them in, they don't just calculate one time. Every time the spreadsheet's changed, if that change impacts the inputs of this formula, it updates. All right, so let's move on to another very basic formula that you can make. And this one doesn't even necessarily have any functions in it. So we'll go to cell E3, and what we want to do, we have a column of units, we have a column of unit cost. As a matter of fact, let me take these costs. I'm going to change the formatting to make it more apparent that it's dollars. Okay, so now we have our units. We want to multiply units times unit cost to get the total in column E, and we'll do that without a function. We're going to use operators. So what we will do, it already guessed it for me. I wasn't expecting that. We were going to do cell C3 times D3. So the C3, as we talked about briefly before, is a cell reference. Okay, so that is column C, row 3. It has to go in that order. You can't do 3C. You have to do C3. And then when you multiply it, you're just using an operator. So we're all familiar with these. You have the basic plus, minus, multiply, and divide. The divide would be a slash, a forward slash like you use on the web. And there are some other operators as well. They're not really in the basic way that you would use sheets, so we'll just stick to these for now. But I guess I'll just accept this formula again. So I will hit tab, and we've multiplied the unit cost by the units. So these formula suggestions, if you're not seeing them, I usually have them turned off for the tutorials that I do, because I'll be doing something more advanced, but it will suggest that basic formula. But if I was just using these to construct data, I'd probably leave them on. If you go to tools and go down to auto complete, all of these are turned on. So it's auto completing for me. It's suggesting formulas. It's even correcting formulas. So let's come out of here. But what we want to do now is we have this formula, but we want to copy it down to rows 4, 5, and 6. But in doing that, we're going to see something very important about spreadsheets. But we'll use a shortcut to do it first. So you see this blue rectangle is indicating that cell E3 is the active cell. That means that that's the one that the formula bar is here if we want to modify it. And it also means that if we hit enter and start typing, that's the one that we're in. But if you go to the lower right-hand corner of the active cell, you'll see a little square. If you hover over that and just drag it down, it will copy down the contents. But this is the important thing in spreadsheets is that it adjusts the rows in this case because it's going down. So in row 4, that formula adjusted. It's no longer C3 times D3. It's C4 times D4. And that happens in all different types of more complex formulas as well. If they get copied down, the row numbers adjust. If they get copied to the right, the columns adjust. All right, so now we've used operators. We've talked about cell references and we've used a function. Instead of summing these, let's say we want the average. Okay, so there's two different ways to get the average. Let's do it the hard way first. So average would be all of them added up divided by all of them counted, right? So the numerator would be what it's suggesting here, but I don't want to grab the header. Let's just make it a little cleaner. So we're going to type it out. Let's do capital letters just to keep the right syntax, but you can do lowercase if you want. And I want to grab E3 through E6, because I really don't want E2. And when I'm counting for the denominator, I definitely don't want to count the word total as 1. So we'll make them both a little tighter here. And there's a couple different ways to grab this cell reference, but one of them is to use our arrow keys. So if I just hit up, we'll go up to where it ends. I'm going to hold down the shift key and I'll keep going up to where it begins. And that's a way to grab a cell reference. I could have also typed it in or I could have selected it with my mouse. Okay, so we have the sum now and you see this blue font that's popping up. That's telling you if you stop typing the function in right now, that would be the result. Okay, but we're not done yet. We want the denominator. So let's do a forward slash. And for the denominator, I said we want how many items there are. So there's a couple of functions that count values. They count them in different ways. We're going to use the function that counts non-blank cells. There are, one variation would be a formula that just counts the numbers. So you actually could use that with the header because it would ignore it, but this is cleaner. So count A, but let's back up one. What you're seeing below here is called formula suggestions. So it's kind of like when you type into a search engine and it gives you all the autocomplete suggestions. This is telling you all the functions that start with the letters that you've already typed. And when you go down through them, you can kind of look at the descriptions to decide which ones you want. And I want the one that just counts. Well, really, I think I just want count the number of numeric values. But if I use count A, the number of any type of value in a data set, it would give the same result because I have a good cell range here and I can just see it's going to result in 4. But the point of this is not to memorize all the different functions. It's showing you that you can combine functions. So I have the sum function, then I have the operator with the division, and then I have the count function. All of those together is just called a formula, but it's made up of all these parts that we're learning. So for count, it wants the different values. We're just going to give it the same cell range, and this time I'll just type it in, E3 through E6. Hit enter, and I guess the average is $481.97. Now what you could do, and this is the power of all of these named functions, is there's just a function called average. So if you use that function, you don't need to combine two different functions. So we'll use average. I'll show you another way to insert functions. So that help was popping up in the beginning, so we didn't need to do much at all. If you know what you want, you can hit equals and just type it. But if you want to browse them a little bit, you can hit insert, go to function, and they're categorized here. So these are the most common ones, and average is here. But if it wasn't there, you would just go down to math. I think, no, you would go to statistical and go to average. Now, like a lot of the other functions, there's other variations of average. So one important one, and a lot of the functions have this, is average if. So you could say average these if they're over $200. So you only want to look at the average of the higher orders. All sorts of choices here. But we will just select average. And it works like all the other functions. It gives you parentheses, and inside the parentheses, it's waiting for inputs. So for the input here, we'll just do E3 through E6. So you'll notice these cell references that I gave this function are the result of other functions. Okay, so E3 has a, well, it's the result of other formulas. It has a multiplication formula in it, so you can feed a formula into a formula. We'll hit enter, and we get $481.97 again. Let's go back. We'll look at another helpful thing that happens with functions is you don't necessarily see when you get that autocomplete, is if you're thinking about using average, you see it in this list. You can type it all the way to the opening parentheses, and then you get this little bit different looking screen with the green on it. If you drop this down, expand the details, this will give you a little bit of built-in help for each function. So it tells you, it gives you a description, and then tells you about what the inputs are. This can be really helpful if you need more help. If you go to sheetshelp.com, we have pages on most of the common functions. They'll all be there eventually. So you can look it up with examples. So I'll just show you an example here. If you go to sheetshelp.com/average, there's a practice spreadsheet that you can get a copy of. And then videos and examples that you can work through. All right, let's go back to our spreadsheet. And we talked about operators a little bit. So there's the basic plus, multiply, divide, subtract. But there's also a whole host of other operators, but we'll talk about a few that you're familiar with. And they'll come into play in something like what we'll use COUNTIF. So let's look at these values in column E. We'll say we're going to count those if they're less than 200. So I would expect that would return to, could you get the value in E3 and E5? So we will say count if, and then the range. So you're looking at the entire range of E3, and do a colon, right, to go to E6. So that's the cell reference is a range, and the criterion, in this case, is that it is, and you have to surround this in quotes, less than. So less than is an operator. If you want to say less than or equal to, you just put an equal sign after it. And then we will say 200 in that in quotes, hit enter, and it counts two. So there's lots of different things you can do with formulas, but those are all the basics that you need to do, I'd say 95% of what people use spreadsheets for anyway. And if you want to learn more about cell references, like we talked about, the ones that we used in this video were relative cell references. So they'll change when you move them around. You can also fix those cell references or reference other sheets or other files. We're going to talk about that in this next video. So I'll see you in that video. Thanks for watching.